businesses to help bring in that business rates. But of course, as has been pointed out, a substantial top-up is given us into business, but in business rates, more is sent back to us from business rates than we send to London, and it's important that we grow that. A question was raised, and I'll bring it back to Geoff, of course. In our amendment, we want a report back. I understand, I accept the courtesies, I accept the eye that Councillor Jones, the Cabinet Member, brings to this. She did say she was absolutely confident that alternatives would emerge and be developed. I want to see that. I'm not doubting her courtesy or a word. I want to actually see it. It's a bit like doubting Thomas, putting a hand in the side of the press body, actually being able to see and feel something. Councillor Rennie got, I'm afraid, one of these flights of fantasy. This was about Will's appalling treatment of the vulnerable. I think the case was overstated. I think that in many care homes, staff are working hard to provide it. We're introducing checks on those care homes, greater checks on those care homes. I listened, I understand, Councillor Rennie talked about the care her family had to give to the frail and the vulnerable. One of those answers, when I come back to lobbying, is to make sure that any formula brought in by the government recognises local needs, recognises local costs, and that's why I will work to try and achieve that. Mr. Mayor, we've produced some comments on the budget which, if you haven't accepted, we'll come back to a further council meeting. It's in the light of asking members to look at those issues as I do that, and I hope members will support it.
Councillor Green, I don't have a problem. Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and can I also thank a number of members in terms of what they said about our amendment, particularly Wendy. Yes, I think it is important we are concerned about what's happening in terms of the hub and whether we need to support that more effectively, and I think we think we do. Adam, in terms of what about allowing local people to take more control over their services and how the current administration seems to be working against that, I think that is a point really well made, and it's something that's been addressed at this amendment too. David's comment with regards to making sure and Jerry in terms of caring and really and truthfully given the scale of the budget, some of the things we've read, the points we've identified, can 155,000 pieces, that is the same that's listed in the budget, can that not be found in order to support the people and the users of Gertrude Court? And clearly it could be, and those points were really well made. Bit of a shame that some of the other comments, but again, just to help, Mr. Mayor, you will note that we refrained in our budget proposal from withdrawing taxpayer funding to trade union officials, which still cost the authority £130,000. We've listened, Mr. Mayor, and at times of great change, our staff may wish to call on resources provided by the trade unions. However, in return for that funding, I think the council must be assured that its decision offers value for money to Wirral County taxpayers. So we did require trade union representatives funded by the authority to produce an annual report to be received by the council detailing their activities throughout the year. And Mr. Mayor, we think that is a reasonable and welcome innovation that our staff and trade unions could actually highlight at a time of great change. So, best reading something before you start criticising, I would suggest. And Mr. Mayor, you will recall that last year I warned that unless there was greater ambition, discipline, rigour, risk management, and political accountability, the identified programme change would not deliver the structural changes required for the council. At that time, we also recommended the establishment of a trade board or party basis to be led by the leader of the council. Clearly, the more proposed demand that any party, any council represents anywhere that actually Conservatives vote for aren't part of their vision about what it is. It seems now 2020 has become a Labour Party slogan, presided over by the Labour Party, and having Labour Party champions. So more or less. We did, and that's why I'm somewhat disappointed that the Labour Party have once again been reverted back, and as Councillor Fox walked to that, they have reverted back to this tribal politics. Now, Mr. Murph, reverted back to tribal politics. Mr. Murph,
well, I never reverted back to tribal politics once in my speech.
Well, it gives me no pleasure to
do you apologise?
It gives me great pleasure, it gives me no pleasure at all to point out that we told you so. It is deeply disappointing that 9.6 million of the proposed change programme for 15-16 was not delivered in 15-16. In fact, very much of a bunch of papers, we found an £11.2 million fund set up for the 2016-2017 budget. No doubt on the basis that Labour administration will yet again fail to deliver cash flow benefits from a portfolio change. Mr. Mayor, Councillor Davis's determination not to listen or manage a transformational programme properly remains deeply worrying, and as his £11.2 million cost of incompetence contingency demonstrates, expensive to the hard-working taxpayers in rural. I would suggest, Mr. Mayor, he starts listening to people who know about managing change. And also, Mr. Mayor, takes time to look at successful high reliability organisations and the behaviour they instill and expect. Perhaps then he will think again about agreeing to the establishment of a strategic change board on an all-party basis. Mr. Mayor, there's not much more that can be done, or there's so much more that can be done to reduce council costs while protecting frontline services. Council membership could be reduced by a third to say 223,000. We should be investigating becoming self-sufficient in energy, which has the potential to save £2.4 million, and to share IT, payroll, finance, legal, procurement services with other organisations in the Wirral Partnership, or indeed Cheshire West and Chester Local Authority, which, if done properly, has the potential to save millions of pounds. It appears, Mr. Mayor, while the Labour Group is prepared to close Gertrude Court, they are content to leave other opportunities on the too-hard-to-do pile. Mr. Mayor, we believe that our budget amendment we put forward does keep children and young people safe, does protect our most vulnerable residents, does bear down unnecessary spending, and in addition, and for the avoidance of doubt, it will most certainly keep Gertrude Court open, and I commend it to the Council.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I start off by asking, by just making a point really? What planet is Leslie Rennie on? She thinks that public services are flourishing.
But there's something about personal offences, Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Mayor.
Can I get some time? I'm just pointing out of the floor. Excuse me.
I did say at the beginning of this session that I will be strict on personal.
Yes.
The reality that we all know is that public services in this country are at breaking points. Go into any hospital, look at what the police are coping with. Look at any public service, look at councils, look at the fire authority. Those public services are greedy because of the cuts of your government, and it's frankly disgraceful that you're not prepared to stand up to what's going on with your Tory government. Yeah. Because basically what they've done is they've put a few kind of headline-catching items in. And if you look at all of their spending pledges, that they're paid for by massive, massive cuts in our staff. You know, the lowest paid. There's no negotiations with trade unions. One of my colleagues mentioned it. They're just going to get rid of enhancements. They will hit the lowest paid staff. That's how they're paying for their election promises. And, you know, I need to just make a comment about the extra social workers. Yes, I've
that for you.
Mr. Mayor, would you please?
I just asked.
Shut him up. I think we just need, this is a really serious point. In the light of the editorial amendment, I asked the Director of Children's Services for a note on the multi-agency safeguarding hub. Contrary to what is said in the Tory amendment, the Director does not believe that there are issues about current capacity of the MASH to manage referrals. And therefore, whilst I absolutely accept never be complacent, I think to suggest otherwise, I think, is disingenuous. And, okay, you know, we could also talk, can I say to Wendy, five extra social workers, great, but you're cutting the essential car allowances, so they won't be able to get to work. They won't have to use their cars, because you're cutting their essential car allowances. So, listen there, and then we have the other sort of chest, the old chest that Jeff brings out every year. We've got 100 million in reserves, These reserves are to pay for things like insurance, VAT, all the things that local authorities, a good employer, have to have in our reserves. We've got modest balances next year of 11.5 million. And the reason why we've had to put money in a revenue contingency pot is because of the massive cuts that you're going to make, including all the revenue support grants. That is prudent financial planning in my view. So, the other point I wanted to make is transformational change programme. No, Jeff, I won't be recommending to council that we agree to set up an all-party strategic change programme. Mr. Mayor, this party runs this council. Yeah. Jeff Green is no longer the leader. He needs to be elected. This is about giving...
it's not about choice.
...disabilities more choice. It is.
Crap.
And the reality is, we have a number, because I've spoken to the director, we have a number of people who can't exercise a choice over the go to that one building.
What about the 40 staff?
We need to look at other options. So the commitment from this party is, yes, everybody who currently receives a respite care will continue to receive that care going forward. Yes, we will do our one-to-ones properly. We won't be rushed. We'll take the time that we need to do.
Give us a timeline then, please.
We will put viable alternatives.
Could you give us a timeline on that, please?
We'll remain open until we've got those viable alternatives in place.
1 year? 5 years? How long?
Chris, excuse me, I'd like to hear the debate.
And Chris, if that requires us to open, keep it open beyond June, we'll look at that.
Mr. Mayor, I didn't go through anyone's private emails. I put in an echo
pledges to the people of Wirral. This is the kind of tactics we were seeing.
Mr.
Mayor, the nasty party is alive and well, and it's sitting in that side of the chair. It does deal with all our pledges. It does look after our vulnerable people. It keeps alive our principles around social justice. It is a good budget. It is a sustainable budget. And I commend that to the council.
Thank you, councillors. And moving on to the voting now. Now, voting for the recorded vote shall be on Councillor Gilchrist's budget amendment. Councillors should clearly state whether they are voting for, against, for or against, or abstaining. Right. On Councillor Gilchrist's amendment, all those for.
Councillor Gilchrist's amendment.
Councillor Abbey.
Councillor
Anderson.
Four.
Councillor Berry.
Four.
being sorted out, can we not now move to the main vote on the Labour?